So we're trying to touch the foot of our opponent so that we can capture the center of our opponent via that method. Now the idea is that we can transmit or read, more accurately, read information inside our body. If you can't take and read inside the body, you can't capture it. So some of you will feel like it's very difficult to feel their foot. That's normal. It's here. Now, to increase our ability to read information inside the body, there's two ways. One, compress the tissue so that it becomes tighter and transmits the information more. Yeah? Does that make sense? Two, stretch their tissue so it becomes tighter and transmits the information more. Yeah? So if you grab someone, so say you stand slowly through the door, I can't read his body. Yeah? Because I can't read the information. Yeah? So I have to be able to stretch the body inside. Yeah? If I can stretch his tissue, I stretch it and then I can control it. Or I compress it. I compress the tissue inside his body. Then it goes. If I do not compress or stretch the tissue, I can not control it. It's like this. Right? Nothing happens. I have to find a way to connect to his being so I can read or to his being. If I cannot take his being, I cannot control it. Tai Chi is based on qi. Cannot think, cannot control. Yeah? So when I touch, nothing. I have to find out, you feel the difference? Now I have the answer. If I don't touch, I cannot control it. Here, nothing. Nothing, nothing, nothing. I have it work. We must find a way to touch the furthest point, the foot, and the closest point, the contact point. Somewhere between there is their center. But if you cannot read what's between those two points, it's useless. That's why we saw, one of the reasons we saw. So you can't read me, I'm sorry. Right? You can't read me because I'm sorry. But if you compress me, I'm no longer sorry. If you stretch me, I'm no longer sorry. Yeah? So a lot of people do the form like this and they really stretch too much, externally stretching. They put themselves in that extremely readable state. You don't want to be in that extremely readable state. It's a bad place to be. Because as soon as someone touches you, they can be. Yeah. So we push. Okay? Nothing happens. Right? I have to make you a little bit. You feel stiff, right? If you're not stiff, you cannot control it. How can I control a bad water? Yeah? When he's trained, so he doesn't need to be short, I cannot do it. I have to turn his body water into ice. I have to find a way to do it. Cannot do it. That's what we do. We must be able to make their body water ice. Touch the far point, touch the close point. Compress it or stretch it. That's all. Later, you don't need to compress or stretch it. Now you need to compress or stretch it. Because you can't read inside. Later, when the neurology is built enough and the habits built enough and your chi is intelligent enough to read, then you don't need to compress to read inside. You don't need to stretch to read inside. Because the chi is already intelligent. But when you can't do it via chi, you need to do it via the mechanical method of compressing the tissue in your body or stretching the tissue in your body so you can read it. So when we're doing the drill, the chai drill, we go like this, right? Why do we do this? Look what I'm doing. I've stretched this point all the way down.